Setting up WebRTC requires the most recent version of Wowza Streaming Engine, as well as SSL or TLS encryption. To get started, we'll first go to wowza.com and click My Account at the top to sign in. Once you're signed in, go to the Stream Lock tab and enter your Wowza Streaming Engine license key. You'll also need to enter the public IP address for your Wowza Streaming Engine instance and a certificate password. Once all this has been entered, click Apply for SSL Certificate. When the application's complete, the certificate will appear under My SSL Certificates. You'll be referencing the host name from this point further as your secure host. Download the certificate and move the certificate file to your Wowza Streaming Engine installation under the CONF directory. This process will vary depending on your operating system. Now, we can access our Wowza Streaming Engine Manager to configure the use of the SSL certificate. Go under Server and select Virtual Host Setup. Click on Edit and then scroll down to select Add Host Port. Here we can add a host port for the Stream Lock. Name it as such, leaving the type as streaming, a wildcard for the IP address, and set the port to 443. Now check Enable SSL Stream Lock and enter the path to the Stream Lock certificate. The path should have this format as shown below, with the name being the first part of the host name. You can find it back in your Wowza account. Once this information has been entered correctly, add the certificate password from when you first applied for the SSL certificate and check Use WebRTC. After the port has been added and saved, be sure to restart the virtual host before we begin adding our WebRTC features. Under Applications, go to your application that will be using WebRTC. In this example, we'll use the Live default. Under WebRTC, click Edit and check the specified features you wish to be enabled. We'll check Publish WebRTC to Wowza Streaming Engine in order to ingest WebRTC source streams to this application, Play WebRTC from Wowza Streaming Engine to deliver WebRTC content for playback from this application, and Query Published Stream Names to enable querying names from published WebRTC streams for this application. Under ICE Candidate Setup, if adding UDP, which we recommend, you just need to enter the IP address for your Wowza Streaming Engine instance. For TCP candidates, we'll add an ICE candidate. We'll also need to specify the port to use for WebRTC streaming. We may also choose to add additional codecs or even change the priority of what codec to use. Once we've saved our new settings, we'll also need to restart the application for changes to take effect. Now we can test streaming WebRTC through Wowza Streaming Engine by using our hosted test pages. Click Open WebRTC Publish page, adding our signaling URL, which should start with WSS:// then contain your host name / WebRTC-session.json. Enter the application name, which in this case is Live, and the stream name, which is whatever we want to call the stream. We can change the codec and sources, but for now, we'll just go straight to publish. Once we're live, we'll see live in the corner of our video screen. Back in Wowza Streaming Engine Manager, we can go to incoming streams to confirm our WebRTC stream is being ingested. To play the stream as WebRTC, go back to WebRTC and select Open WebRTC Play page. Again, we'll need to enter our signaling URL, application name, and stream name. Hit play, and we'll see the live stream using the WebRTC protocol. To see the latency, we may want to adjust the browser windows so we can see both the publish and playback screens at the same time. That's it for using WebRTC with Wowza Streaming Engine. Thanks for watching, and happy streaming.